Blue Origin finally launched New Glenn. But what exactly happened during the launch? Let's discuss. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. Blue Origin, the aerospace company founded by Amazon's Jeff Bezos, achieved a significant milestone with the successful test flight of its New Glenn rocket on the early morning of January 16, 2025. This launch marked the company's first venture into placing a payload into Earth's orbit, a feat that had eluded Blue Origin since its inception in the private space race. The New Glenn rocket, named in honor of the first American to orbit Earth, John Glenn, lifted off from Launch Complex 36 at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station in Florida at precisely 2:03 a.m. Eastern Time. The rocket, standing at an impressive 320 feet, 98 meters tall, was a spectacle to behold as it rose from the same historic pad that once sent NASA's Mariner and Pioneer spacecraft into space decades ago. This launch site had seen significant investment from Blue Origin, with over $1 billion poured into rebuilding Complex 36 to accommodate the Behemoth rocket. The primary objective of the mission, dubbed NG-1, was to test the communications and control systems for Blue Ring, a multi-mission space mobility platform Blue Origin is developing. This platform aims to facilitate greater in-space mobility, particularly for military applications as part of a Defense Innovation Unit program. The launch itself was a spectacle, with the countdown culminating in a fiery ascent powered by 7 BE-4 engines on the first stage, which utilized liquefied natural gas, and 2 hydrogen-fueled BE-3U engines on the second stage. The combined thrust at liftoff was approximately 3.8 million pounds, which is roughly half of what the Saturn V moon rockets achieved during the Apollo era. Post-liftoff, the mission followed a meticulously planned trajectory. After the initial boost, the first and second stages separated. The second stage then continued to propel the payload into a highly elliptical orbit, ranging from 1,490 to 12,000 miles. 2,400 to 19,300 kilometers in altitude, testing the capabilities of the in-space system at various heights. The primary payload for this mission was the Blue Ring Pathfinder, demonstrating technologies for future Blue Ring vehicles. However, not everything went according to plan. The first stage booster aimed to land autonomously on a custom-built barge named Jacqueline in honor of Jeff Bezos's mother, missed its mark. The booster, humorously nicknamed "So You're Telling Me There's a Chance," failed to achieve the soft landing, falling into the Atlantic Ocean instead. Despite this setback, Blue Origin's launch commentator Ariane Cornell emphasized that the mission's success was defined by reaching orbit, not by the booster's landing. The mission was expected to last about 6 hours, with the second stage designed to place itself in a safe, high orbit to minimize the creation of space debris, in line with NASA's guidelines. This was part of a broader commitment by Blue Origin to sustainable space travel. The launch was not just a technical test, but also a statement of Blue Origin's ambitions in the space industry. Bezos expressed optimism about the future, envisioning 6 to 8 New Glenn flights in 2025, with the next scheduled for spring. He also highlighted the non-competitive nature of the space industry, suggesting there's room for multiple players like Blue Origin alongside SpaceX, which has dominated with its Falcon 9, and Starship rockets. The implications of this launch are vast. Success with New Glenn opens up numerous possibilities for Blue Origin, from supporting satellite constellations like Amazon's Project Kuiper for broadband internet, to participating in NASA's lunar missions with the Blue Moon Lander. Furthermore, New Glenn's capability to launch payloads significantly heavier than what was possible with previous systems like NASA's Space Shuttle positions Blue Origin as a formidable player in space logistics. However, the journey to this point was fraught with challenges. The BE-4 engine, central to New Glenn's power, had seen its share of developmental hurdles. The delay from an initially planned launch in October of the previous year for NASA's Escapade Mars mission was one example of these challenges. Despite these hurdles, the successful orbit insertion of the satellite marked a new chapter for Blue Origin, proving its capabilities beyond suborbital flights, which it had been conducting since 2021 with New Shepard. The launch also had political undertones, occurring just days before the change in NASA's leadership with President-elect Donald Trump set to take office. The incoming NASA administrator, Jared Isaacman, known for his private space ventures with SpaceX, would have a new dynamic competitor in Blue Origin, whose success could influence future space policy and commercial partnerships. In conclusion, Blue Origin's New Glenn launch was a pivotal moment, not just for the company, but for the broader narrative of commercial space travel. It showcased the capability of the private sector in pushing the boundaries of what's possible in space, underscored by a blend of technological prowess, strategic vision, and the inevitable learning from less than ideal outcomes like the booster landing failure. This launch was not just about what happened in those few hours on that January morning, but about opening new avenues for humanity's journey into space. I'd like to quickly remind you to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. You know, we're on a mission to reach 65,000 subscribers by next week. Join us on this journey, and let's see if we can make it happen together. The journey of Sierra Space's Dream Chaser spaceplane, a vehicle heralded for its potential to revolutionize cargo delivery to space, has encountered yet another delay, pushing its long-awaited inaugural flight to no earlier than May 2025. This delay marks a significant shift from the previously anticipated launch within the current year, reflecting the complex nature of aerospace engineering and the stringent safety protocols that govern space travel. Dream Chaser, named Tenacity for its first mission, is slated for launch aboard the United Launch Alliance's Vulcan Centaur expendable rocket, a pairing that underscores the collaborative efforts between private space enterprises and established aerospace giants. Currently stationed at NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida, Tenacity has undergone extensive testing to ensure its readiness for the harsh conditions of space. From vibration and thermal vacuum tests at NASA's Neil Armstrong Test Facility in Sandusky, Ohio, to acoustic and electromagnetic interference, EMI tests at Kennedy, the spaceplane has been subjected to a rigorous regimen designed to simulate the myriad challenges of spaceflight. This testing phase is crucial not only for the safety of the mission, but also for validating the design and construction of both the Dream Chaser and its companion, the Shooting Star Cargo Module. The Shooting Star Module, integral to Dream Chaser's cargo capabilities, will be attached to Tenacity for its maiden voyage to the International Space Station, ISS. This module will carry essential supplies like science gear, food, and other cargo, accessible via the spaceplane's aft hatch, once berthed to the station by a robotic arm. The collaboration with NASA under the Commercial Resupply Service 2, CRS-2, contract highlights the strategic importance of Dream Chaser in the ongoing support and sustenance of the ISS. Simultaneously, Sierra Space isn't resting on the laurels of Tenacity alone. The development of the second Dream Chaser, Reverence or DC-102, is progressing, albeit with its timeline contingent on the return of the engineering team to Colorado. Once back, it's estimated that another 18 months will be needed to complete Reverence, setting the stage for a fleet capable of up to 30 missions between the two craft, as each Dream Chaser is designed for 15 trips. This expansion not only showcases Sierra Space's commitment to scalability in space logistics, but also their strategic foresight in meeting the increasing demand for in-space infrastructure. Beyond cargo, Sierra Space's vision extends to crewed and national security variants of the Dream Chaser, labeled the DC-200 and DC-300 series respectively. These developments indicate a versatile future for the platform, potentially catering to a broad spectrum of missions from human spaceflight to sensitive governmental operations. In parallel, Sierra Space is advancing its in-space habitat technology through the Large Integrated Flexible Environment Life Habitat Project. Utilizing Vectrin, a high-strength polymer fiber, the company is pioneering the construction of inflatable habitats. These structures, tested for durability, radiation protection, and resistance to micrometeoroids and orbital debris, represent a leap towards more expansive and sustainable living environments in space. The testing at NASA's White Sands Test Facility involves firing projectiles at hypervelocity speeds to simulate space debris impacts, ensuring that the materials can withstand the harshness of space. The Life Habitat's development is part of a broader roadmap that envisions increasingly larger, expandable structures. Sierra Space has already tested full-scale prototypes and smaller modules, gathering invaluable data that informs the design of future habitats. A three-story model on the factory floor, boasting 285 cubic meters of volume, with innovative features like built-in windows, signifies the practical application of these concepts. Furthermore, Sierra Space is not just building hardware, but also the human infrastructure to operate it. A new mission control center at their facilities is now operational, staffed by about a dozen specialists with capabilities to downscale during less intensive mission phases. Training is intensive, involving simulated missions that occasionally include joint operations with NASA and United Launch Alliance. This approach ensures that when Dream Chaser does fly, it does so under the most prepared and stress-tested team possible. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.